Hi everyone, my name is Hitoishi and welcome back to the Sociology classes with me for batch IAC 2022. In the previous video, I have discussed about social institution and kinship, and in this video, as promised, I will be going to discuss about kinship usages. Before starting, I want to remind once again that what is kinship? So kinship is a bond of blood or marriage that binds people together. Okay. So first, what does kinship usage means? Kinship usages are the guidelines provided for interaction among various persons in various groups. Means it provides us the guidelines how to react to someone, how a person should behave with another person in various groups. Okay. They define the proper acceptable role relationships like between father and daughter. There are six types of kinship usages. One is avoidance. Number two is joking relationship. Number three is technonymy. Number four is avunculate. Number five is imitate. And number six is covet. First, we will be discussing avoidance. Avoidance rules are practiced between persons who are affinely related, that means by marriage. Okay, so it may also exist between blood ties, means those who are related by blood. Okay, but mainly avoidance rule is practiced between, suppose, a person and his mother-in-law. Suppose, a woman and father-in-law. Between them, avoidance rule is practiced, means there is no attraction. There is respect on both the side. So this is known as avoidance. There is no attraction. Okay. Similarly, in case of blood ties, we have relationship between brother and sisters. There is a practice of avoidance rule. Okay. No attraction. Next, we have joking relationships. So many societies provide joking relationships with certain kins, generally of opposite sex. These relationships express a form of friendliness by a show of mild hostility. Okay, like they are expected not to take offense but respond in kind. This kind of relations are mostly found among a person and his brother's wife. Okay, also found in grandparents and grandsons. Like you may have found that our grandparents may tease us sometimes. Okay, you can't react to that. You have to take it properly. You can't react. Okay, you can't take offense. You have to respond kindly to that joke. So this is known as joking relationships. Then we come to technonymy. Technonymy is a practice which involves calling a married person not by his or her name but by their child's name. Like in earlier days, we have heard a wife calling her husband as Priya's papa, means Priya ka papa. Okay, Priya ke papa. Then similarly, a husband calling his wife as Priya ki mummy. So we have heard this, it's general. Then we have imitate, where the person's sister, that is in Hindi we also call Bua, occupies a pivotal role in family and enjoys more respect than the mother. It's simple. Okay. Then we have avunculate. And in this case, it's just the opposite one. Okay. The maternal uncle, hope you remember what is maternal uncle. It is mama, means mother's brother. The maternal uncle comes first among the male line. He has more pride. Okay. Lastly, we have covet. This is a common practice among the Todas. Todas are a tribal group. Okay. Among Todas, when the wife is pregnant, the husband behaves as if he is also pregnant. He leaves his active life, means he takes a leave from his work, and goes on a sick diet and observes some sorts of prohibition like a pregnant wife does. Okay, this is known as covet. So here are the six types of kinship usages. Our next topic is marriage. Let us know the definition first. Okay, marriage according to reverse. So remember, when we say when you will write a definition like according to Rivers or any other sociologists, remember to give quotation. Okay, if you can learn the proper definition, you have to give quotation. And if you can't learn the proper exact definition, please do not give quotation. So there the teacher will cut your marks. Remember this. So let's come back. According to Rivers, marriage is a union between two opposite sex regulating their sex relationship. There are some rules of marriage which you have heard before. Okay. So number one is exogamy and endogamy. Exogamy refers to the prohibition of marriage between individuals who may be members of same group. Okay, from same group, if they are from same group, then marriage is prohibited between them. They can't marry each other. There are some types of exogamy. Number one is gotra exogamy. People having same gotra are considered to be sharing the same blood and hence marriage is prohibited between them. Means individuals having same gotras can't marry each other. Number two, we have provar exogamy. Provar means religious or spiritual bond. So marriage between persons are again prohibited if they are from same provar. This is found among Hindus, especially in Brahmins. Means provar is specially found among the Brahmins. Then we have village exogamy. This is mainly practiced among the Munda tribes. Okay. They practice marriage outside the village. Means individuals of same village can't marry each other in case of village exogamy. And it is mainly practiced among the Munda tribes. Then we have Pinda exogamy. Pinda refers to common parentage. According to Brihaspati, offspring of 5 maternal and 7 paternal generation. Maternal means from mother's generation and paternal means from father's generation. So they are not supposed to marry each other as because they are becoming cousins. So here ends the types of exogamy. Now what is endogamy? It is just the opposite one. This is the practice of marrying within a specific group that was prohibited among the specific group, and this is marrying among the specific group. Here, marrying outside the group is prohibited, just the opposite one. Okay. Why prohibited? Just to preserve their unity, their homogeneity and status. So a common question comes from this part, that is, differentiate between endogamy and exogamy. You have to just remember these points and you have to write the answer. So in this video, I have discussed about kinship usages and about marriage. There are some more types of marriage which I will be going to discuss in the next video. So again, I hope you enjoyed learning sociology with me. Meeting you soon in the next video. Till then, keep watching Akash Talks.